What about Elvis? You say he was a sweet, sweet guy. You guys starred in Flaming Star, obviously.
Yeah.
Tell me about Elvis.
Oh, he was a dear. He was just a dear, and very, very earnest. He wanted to be an actor. He wanted to do well. He talked to me about a lot of things. I think I've told you about the girl that he was in love with that he finally married. But he also would talk about the colonel. You know, he'd say, you know, people say I shouldn't be with the colonel, but he said, if it wasn't for the colonel, I'd still be singing in those little places and, you know, in Kentucky or wherever, you know, Tennessee, for two bits. So he said, I can't get rid of the colonel.
What did you think of that?
I don't think I thought anything about that.
Because he's right. He's right in a sense. And there's obviously something to, you know, it's admirable he was loyal, but...
Yes, but I didn't really think... How can you judge something that's happening? In retrospect, of course, I could judge it. But at that point, it was happening. He was working. He was doing a wonderful part in this movie. He went on to do some awful movies, but sold a lot of money.
Yeah.
You know, sold a lot of tickets. Our film didn't sell too many. It was a good film, got good reviews. He played a half-breed who didn't get the girl, didn't sing, and died. His fans didn't want that.
Yeah.
They wanted the popcorn and candy and, you know, the so of course that's what the colonel put him in after that. He didn't have to do that though. He could have been really, really wonderful and on film.
Yeah. What was your last, I know you saw him one last time before he passed away. Tell me about the last time you saw Elvis and what you felt.
Well, I saw him in Las Vegas, and he was wonderful. He was electric. He was fabulous. I did not see him when he was fat and really down and out, but I did follow him in a venue in Reno. And I happened to get a have a cold at that time, and, you know, singers, you get a cold, you go, and immediately, find me a doctor. And and they did. And the man gave me a shot and gave me some antibiotics, and the cold was gone like that. And the man who'd sent me to the doctor said, don't ever go back to him again. He said, this is a one-time thing. And I said, why? He said, because you don't want those shots. He said, Elvis was here just before you, and he said he was a mess. He was a mess. He said, I was there with him when he got the shot. And it said his bottom looked like leather. So many needle marks. So I don't know what the shot was. I assumed it was cortisone, but I don't think so.
Yeah.
It
would
have been something else. But he just had people steering him in the wrong way. He loved to sing. He loved to entertain. It was his life. And I think if someone told him he had to do something in order to sing, he'd probably do it.
Yeah.
You know, without thinking about the consequences. And I think his dad was gone by then. His mother was gone. He had no one. Wrong people.
When you heard about his passing, were you surprised?
I was surprised. I was very surprised, yeah. But, you know... Everything's in retrospect now, you know. At the time, I was shocked. Yes. But aren't you always, when someone passes that you know very well and you know they're ill, but you're still shocked when they transcend? You say, whoa, what happened? That doesn't happen.
Yeah, always.